everyone.
Hi.
Welcome to another episode of True Talk. Yay. Season 3. So happy to have you join us, and we have someone special in our midst. We have a man of God,
a brother,
a friend,
a drama minister.
Oh my God,
transformational
evangelist.
Oh, yes,
wow. Out of the century. I'm sure this face is probably familiar.
Yes,
we have minister, evangelist,
brother.
Toby Olumuyiwa, thank you so much for joining us. I'm so happy. Happy to have you here.
It's a great privilege being here. I do not take it for granted. Thank you very much.
Thank you,
sisters.
Thank you.
Let us prosper this ministry.
Amen. All right, so for those who have been wondering, transformational ranting. Yes, and he is the transformational ranter. Yeah. So if you're wondering what is transformational ranting, stay tuned and watch this short video and be blessed.
What's your problem? Hello, good morning. My name is Toby Olumuyiwa or Genemaru. What is your problem? Today we'll be discussing a serious topic, which is envy. Envy is the brother and sister to jealousy, to hatred, to covetousness, to wrath. They have various family members. Look at what you are nursing in your heart. Envy, and you think envy will stay alone there. They will come along with their brothers and sisters, their family members. You are nursing envy in your heart. What is your problem? Is it a bad thing? Stick with your own thing. Because that sister can act drama than you. Because that brother can sing better than you. Because that person can play instrument better than you. You are now nursing envy. You are nursing envy in your heart. You need to flush out envy from your body. Cry to the Holy Ghost to help you to flush it out of your body. You better change. My name is Toby Olumuyiwa Genemaru. I am begging you, remove envy from your life, and the Lord will bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you very much. I remain Toby Olumuyiwa Genemaru. What is your problem? Eshe?
Welcome back. So that is called transformational ranting, and I'm sure you picked one or two things from that ranting. So.
And you were blessed by it.
And we're going to be talking about bitterness today. Bitterness. We're going to be going through a number of, you know, subtopics on the topic bitterness. So, sir, what do you think bitterness is? What exactly is bitterness?
Well, I'm seeing bitterness as a seed, a poisonous seed that can be so silent that you won't even know it's inside you. Bitterness is a mother to anger, to jealousy, to envy, to every kind of behavior you can see as a reaction towards another person or yourself. I mean negative. Reaction. So bitterness is a poisonous seed, very poisonous. That we should all, you won't know you have bitterness if you are not intentional about guarding your loins, about watching your gates, the gates of your heart. It's bitterness can occupy a very small seat in your heart and you won't know. So bitterness is it's something that kills the heart. It can lead one to suicide. It can lead one to suicide if not well taken care of.
Thank you very much for that explanation. I mean, one thing that I picked is when he said that you can be bitter against something and not even know that you're bitter. So which means we have to be intentional. We have to be intentional about evaluating ourselves, you know, placing our hearts before God and telling him to shine his light on it, to really check if we're still in place and if there's no crooked path. You know, Ella, what do you think about
this? Yes, and you also said that it's a seed. Right, so it means it can grow, and then every seed in the right environment grows. So it might just, you know, be very, very little. The seed is a small, it can occupy a small part in your heart, but then the seed does not need a very big expanse of land, just very little, and can become a tree and bring fruit. And like I said, fruits can now be suicide, depression, and all these things. So the fact that it's just still little at a particular point in time doesn't mean you should overlook it or neglect it. It means you should pay so much attention to it and operate it and fill up this void that it has taken up.
I'd like to add that bitterness can be both outwards and inwards. So you can be bitter towards other people and you can also be bitter towards yourself. and both of them are bad. There's no good word to eat. So there's no like good fruit that bitterness can produce. It's always bad.
It's always bad. And I think that's even the most dangerous. Bitter, like being bitter with yourself, because you cannot like leave yourself somewhere and go somewhere. You can't, like, you carry yourself. So it's like wherever you go, even if someone comes to you with joy, something with like every good news is gray for you, because you are just like, because you're not happy with yourself, and that's very, very poisonous and terrible. We know that definitely there are characteristics of bitterness. There are symptoms of bitterness, things that show that, okay, you're exhibiting this trait, so you're definitely bitter. There is a root of bitterness inside of you. So what do you think are those, you know, characteristics?
Okay, when you notice you are always sad, you always want to be alone, wanting to please yourself in that sad mood, wanting some thoughts come into your mind that is close to quenching life out of you.
Or depressing too.
Exactly. Just know that you are exhibiting something close to bitterness. And also, when you notice you always want to fight for yourself, you always want to defend yourself, being vengeful. Let me stop there.
Yes, those are very true, legitimate points.
Yes, another characteristic is hate. When you hate a person, or you hate, you know, maybe the name of the person is mentioned, that you just have hate boiling within you, like, why? Like, whatever about the person just comes up, you just feel this hate.
Your mood changes.
And also anger too. You just become angry. Like, you want to maybe hurt the person. You want to get rid of the person. You want to just, you know, want the worst thing to happen to the person. I believe that in that case, a person is bitter. Like, you know, bitter against the person. Hate and anger.
And I just want to also add, like, when you are intentionally planning evil for somebody as well, it's that's a result of bitterness. When you are intentionally plotting that, okay, this person must fall, or something bad must happen to this person. You actually go and start making plans and devising
ways
that can happen.
Your church gave you the opportunity to lead praise and worship, but normally, you know, you can sing better than that sister, and you just think, and that mic should not work.
And then you go and tamper with the mic. Maybe a rock. You know, someone that works in the electrical department or instrumentalist, you go and tell them, please just help me to make sure that mic does not work.
That's quite sad. Those are very cogent and practical, you know, symptoms of bitterness. And just to even add what Ella said, when I was in secondary school, I used to say something that if your mood changes just because someone enters your space, it means the person has control over your mood, control over your impressions, control over you. Because it can be so bad that you are eating, joking, laughing, then when someone who hurts you comes, you just walk out of this and say, I'm not interested anymore. As in, a lot of people have been victims. I've been a victim of that. So it's a very common thing that can happen. But just know that it means that person, for the moment in time that you are hateful, you know, you are hateful or you dislike the person, that person has control unknowingly over your space. And then it also means that you're allowing the person to live in your mind rent free. I think I saw that saying. Yes, the person living in your mind, because what you're thinking about is that person or how you hate the person. So that's a very, very important trait and a symptom of bitterness as well. So now that we've listed these symptoms, what are the causes? Because now that we know that, okay, if I have this, it means I'm bitter. But then what can lead to bitterness? What can cause bitterness?
Let's talk about in the world of we youth, breakup. The brother proposed to you, and then something happened. He came and said it won't work. You cried for 6 months. The 6 months that you used to cry, the brother found another person. You first spent a time crying, another time you spent crying because the brother found another person. God now catch you, the brother gets married, you cry another cry, puts to bed. So heartbreak can build a huge room in your heart for bitterness. So please, when heartbreak can happen to anybody, a child of God, a believer, strong heartbreak can happen. It does not even have to be somebody aiming towards marriage. It might be between you and your parents. It might be between you and your seatmates.
Yeah.
Prepare. Once you notice heartbreak, please watch out for bitterness. Watch out for bitterness. It creeps in without you knowing. In fact, you welcome it. It's possible you welcome someone indirectly and unknowingly. You welcome it in your heart and you'll be nursing it against yourself. You see nothing good about yourself.
These are both very cogent and reality, like realistic and practical points. Heartbreak and anger, and then there are other causes. There are other causes of bitterness. Another one is unforgiveness.
Mm.
Maybe if someone hurts you, and hurts you really, really bad, unforgiveness is one of the major causes, because then you become very bitter against this person. And then that's when Tolu's point of bitterness can be outside and inside now comes in the sense that when you're so hurtful and so bitter against somebody, that maybe at a point, say, if the person even leaves your circle, leaves your space, you forget the person. Maybe, okay, probably this offense happened when you were maybe 12 years old, and then 40-something years later. you've forgotten who the person is, the person is even faded, but you just realize that you are so uptight and resentful, and then the bitterness has even left the person completely, and it's now against yourself. Now if someone talks or says something related to how the person hurt you, you become very defensive and very hurtful.
When you remember it.
When you remember it. The person, you can't remember the person again, though, but then you are so hurtful and... So bitterness is so bad. It's so, so bad. So unforgiveness is a major cause of bitterness. Another major cause of bitterness. Can you give us
I think envy is also a major cause of bitterness. Because when you're envious towards somebody, you never see anything good in them. You wish them evil. You want something bad to happen to them because you are not happy with what they're enjoying or what they have. So that can also lead to bitterness.
Another thing that can cause bitterness is abuse. If a person has been abused physically, sexually, emotionally, verbally, you have been abused in the past, and you know, you just develop thick skin for it, or you just develop hatred for the person who abused you, and you become bitter against the person. And maybe, you know, a close relative can be, like, you know, in the movie Baby, for example, she was abused by her father and she was just bitter. The bitterness even spread through to men. She just hated men generally and everything. So abuse, which is also like hurt, you know, having said. And aside abuse, another thing that can cause bitterness is neglect. If a person has been neglected by, you know, his parents or loved ones and was abandoned or was not given enough love, you know, gradually the person just begins to question, oh, why doesn't my father love me? Why is he giving more attention to the church? Why is he giving more attention to his work? And stuff like that. And then gradually, you know, like we said, these things are in stage, progressive, and just unknowingly just becomes bitter against his father. And when the father ever comes home, I got this for you, or my son, I'm proud of you, and all those things, just like, just put him in one corner of your heart. So that's another thing that can cause bitterness.
It's a very cogent point. So I believe we're also taking notes and, you know, evaluating ourselves and thinking that, okay, do I fall into any of these categories? So before we just go on, what are the biblical examples of bitterness? Because definitely there are loads and loads of stories in the Bible that, you know, talk about how people are bitter against another and then this happens. So what are the examples we can get from bitterness?
So Eliezer became bitter. It was just out of envy. You know, after David killed the Goliath and the women were singing for him, and those women took over him So the women were singing for him and hailing David, and at that point Saul was becoming envious. It was a gradual thing. So that happened, Saul started becoming envious. Then the time when Samuel came to Saul and told him that the kingdom of Israel had been taken from him mm-hmm. to somebody else. So all those things gradually, before you knew it, he was bitter. Yes. He was bitter up onto the point he wanted to kill David. God so just initially spared David's life. But there are many occasions when he would have died. He threw the spear at him. He told him to, he placed him to go and kill the Philistines, thinking that the Philistines would kill him. Mm-hmm. So many times, God just spared his life. So bitterness is you know, like we said, it's progressive.
Yeah.
And it doesn't stop at you just being bitter. Many times they want to take an act to hurt the person, to kill, to pull the person down, which is very dangerous, very, very dangerous. Another person or people in the Bible that are also envious, or sorry, that were bitter, are the brothers of Joseph.
Joseph,
they're also bitter. They wanted, and they didn't stop at just being bitter, they wanted to pull him down. So we really have to be careful to search our hearts to be sure that we're not harboring bitterness. Because like we said, you don't just end there, you want to hurt the person, you want to see their downfall. Very dangerous.
Wish them evil, or if you are not in the capacity to do them evil, you want somebody else that is in the capacity to do that evil to them.
And like someone, a saying it goes that blowing out the person's candle does not make yours shine brighter.
Mm.
Because many times you just want to like this person to be hurt. When the person is hurt, it doesn't actually make you better.
Yes.
So just that thing within, that bitterness that makes the person desire another person is hurt, and that's not the will of Christ. That's not the will of the love.
Mm-hmm.
God help us all in Jesus.
Amen. And one major thing that just keeps ringing in my mind even through all this is just the fact that you can be bitter and not know that you're bitter.
It's scary.
Like I can remember a story that I haven't shared with my sisters before we started this true talk of how I heard a story. Particular lady, I'm not sure if she told me or heard from someone of how she was not happy with something. She was not happy with something. Nobody hurt her.
Yeah.
She was just not happy. Like she saw something that's envy. She saw someone do something very well, and then she couldn't do it too. Like she was also in the same field, but then she couldn't do it as well as this person could. So before it was first envy. Then, because the person, what person's business? The person, went about doing his own thing, and she also had no issue with the person. So she was cool with the person. She wasn't even, she wasn't hateful towards the person.
Mm-hmm.
But then she started wallowing in that bitterness that led to inferiority complex.
Mm-hmm.
And even when she got good in what she could do, she couldn't. Like she was blinded to the fact of her gifts.
Mm. Mm.
So she was so good, but she couldn't see the goodness in what she was doing. All she could do was that, I'm not worthy.
Mm.
I'm not good enough.
Mm.
I'm inadequate. Self pity.
Mm.
And she wallowed in that for years.
Mm.
For years. So bitterness is so deadly,
mm-hmm.
and it's a poison that we really, really must be watchful on. And
mm.
there are definitely, ways to get out of bitterness. There are definitely ways to get out of bitterness. Okay, of course, we've shared the causes, unforgiveness, envy, anger. So there are ways to definitely get out of it as there are ways to go into it.
Yes,
I want to just share this scripture with us. It's Hebrews chapter 12, verse 14 and 15. It says, follow peace with all men and holiness, without which no man shall see the Lord. Looking diligently, lest any man fall off the grace of God, lest any root of bitterness spring up, trouble you, and thereby many be defiled. So right here, we are being instructed to follow peace with all men. Follow peace with all men. It's actually an instruction that has to be carried out by all men. It didn't say all men. It has to be carried out. It now says, looking diligently, lest any man fall off the grace of God, lest any root of bitterness springing up trouble you, and thereby many be defiled. Now, the people that Paul was addressing here, they were believers.
Mm-hmm.
They're not unbelievers.
Yes.
So it's very possible to have, be tongue talking. It's so sad, the children of God, they have bitterness, and they cover up with religion. Like they are bitter against their fellow believer, but then they cover up with
activities
and religious works and everything.
You can still be very zealous
and be very bitter. That's how deep bitter.
God opened my eyes to something. Sometimes it's possible for you to even leave your field and go to another man's field because you are bittered towards the person in that other field. So bitterness can collect your assignment from you.
Another work.
God told you to be king over Israel. You're now busy fighting David.
As in, no, do you know what? I've read that scripture and I'm like, I've imagined it. And I've imagined Saul, the king over Israel, carrying 1,000 looking for us. I can imagine how the odds are going to come. Wait, what are you talking about? That the point where Saul says, shall we move? He said, do what you want to do. Do anything, whatever pleases you, do. Because they were tired. It didn't make sense.
It's very, very
can we old men leaving their wives and children thought to be looking for a young boy because of the king's envy?
Going another assignment that God did not send
you. God did not send you. Bitterness can really make somebody.
Yes.
And to Saul, he was doing what seemed right in his eyes. So, like,
I think it clouds your judgment.
It blinds you
from seeing what is important, and you start focusing on
that ephemeral things.
Yes.
So I was reminded of one particular story. I heard it about this particular woman of God who took a mentee under her. So this mentor really, really admired her and loved to be with her, loved to learn from her, you know, to understand the ways of God and how to be a virtuous woman and everything. And she was truly getting good traits, you know, learning, understanding, growing in the Lord and everything. And then she just saw that she was becoming a little more aggressive, a little withdrawn, a little to herself. So she didn't understand what was going on. Till the revelation hit her that the trait of bitterness in her life was coming from somewhere. Because she realized that she couldn't take, like, there was no way of tracing it. You know, imagine if you just start becoming sad and you're wondering why. So then I think of that this particular mentee, she was also, you know, observant, she was sensitive, she was also praying in the spirit, and then she didn't realize that it was coming from somewhere. And it was coming from her mentor. Wow. So she was a woman of God, doing the work of God, but she was harboring bitterness in her heart, and probably she could have forgotten about it and would just manifest and then just go back. And so she was passing that to her mentee without her knowing. And I'm just saying this because of the scripture that says bitterness bring up trouble. Lest any root of bitterness springing up trouble you, and thereby many be defiled. Bitterness, aside from it being physical, it can also be very spiritual. And because there is bitterness, is also a spirit. Spirits, they are not you can't contain them in a person.
In fact, they don't need to knock before they enter you.
Yes.
So far, there is a space.
So far there is a connection, they can, and you have no war, because that lady had submitted to this woman as her mentor, so she was getting those traits as well.
So another way to combat bitterness would be forgiveness. I mean, we talked about unforgiveness. I read somewhere that said that bitterness is fermented unforgiveness. When I heard it, I was just laughing. That means forgiveness you have allowed to, you know, stay, to rot, to just... So forgiveness is very, very important. When you forgive, you let go, you allow God to heal your heart and to help you see the good in other people and wish them well instead of harboring that bitterness and that hatred towards them. So forgiveness is also very, very important. And the Bible commands us to forgive. Forgive us as our sins, as we forgive those who trespass against us. So forgiveness is very, very, very important in combating bitterness.
Yes, and also love. And God is love. So I believe if a person is battling bitterness, just ask God to fill your heart with love. Now, this thing is not something you're going to do by your power. Because, like you said, it's a spirit, it is deadly, it's poisonous. You don't have the power on your own to just say, you know what, but just with the help of the Holy Spirit, you can ask God to please fill your heart with love. Help help me, Lord Jesus, not to be bitter again. Help me to love this person. Help me to forgive this person. Help me to, you know, have a transformed attitude towards this person. The Holy Spirit, you'll be amazed how he will, turn it around and he will help you. So just receive the love of God in your heart and ask God to help you to forgive anybody who has hurt you, to love anybody who has hurt you. And I pray God help us in Jesus' name.
Just to add to the way out, analyze the situation that has led you to bitterness. Don't stay long on it. Move on. Another thing I want to say, one song was just coming to my mind as I was ruminating on this topic. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. It's talking for somebody to be talking to the soul. So it means the soul can hear voices. So be intentional. Speak to yourself, but with the help of God, I overcome this. Mm-hmm. Work towards it. Because it has worked for me. When I was down, I didn't see reasons to thank God. I didn't. Bitterness was coming in. But I'm now putting myself in the shoes of the person that composed that song. Please love myself. Sing like never before. So let's learn as we are moving on. Connect with God. Thank God for where you are.
Mm-hmm.
Speak to your soul. Arise. Arise. It's not what you do mistakenly. You have to be intentional about it.
Yes.
See something good about yourself. Thank God for where you are and where you are going to.
Yes.
And I'm praying victory is ours.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Okay, so do you have anything to add to? I think another important thing to add to everything we said is prayer.
Okay.
Prayer is, you know, very, very important as well. Whatever situation you find yourself, whatever feeling you are feeling, learn to take it to God in prayer.
Mm-hmm.
And God would help you. Mm-hmm. He's going to, you know, come through for you. So prayer is very important as well.
Yeah, still about prayer, not just praying for God to help you, but you can also go the extra length. We said it before in True Talk.
Mm-hmm.
It's not easy, but there's grace to pray for the person that hurts
yes.
you.
Mm-hmm.
It just brings that ease, and you know the body is weak.
Mm-hmm.
There, just bless them, pray for them,
wish them well. Yeah, what's your wish?
Yeah. And then, and also, and lastly, also, just as we know that love is a very strong, you know, tool to combat bitterness,
mm-hmm.
and since we know that God is love,
mm-hmm.
like, you know, like Ella rightly said, it means once we draw close to Him, we can, you know, be able to get those doses of love from
yeah.
Him, because if we see that it's really hard to love this person, draw close
to
the one that is love
yeah.
mm.
and get doses of
yeah.
love from
yeah.
to love that person.
Yes. Love versus yeah. cover the multitude.
Multitude. So when you love someone, it's just like our parents now that love us, you know, regardless of whatever we do, they love us. So once you draw close to the Lord and you spend time in a secret place, just fellowshipping with Him,
mm-hmm.
and then praying intentionally
mm-hmm.
for the person. And praying for love for yourself, then you will be surprised of the miracle that will go on in your heart and the deliverance you have. Because bitterness is actually shackles.
Mm-hmm.
Like a person can be shackled with bitterness.
Mm-hmm.
You can be shackled, so it's a prison.
Mm-hmm.
And it's amazing how I think I've been in that state before of how someone really, really hurts me so bad, and I was battling with unforgiveness,
mm-hmm.
and I had to just talk to God. So it was my secondary school days, and a young girl really offended me, and you know, she has been offending me like in close proximity,
mm-hmm.
you know. So it was really, it wasn't easy for me, because when someone offends you over and over and over again, it can lead to bitterness, straight up bitterness. So that particular night, I just didn't feel like going out, you know, to play or to, you know, mingle. So I was just with God, fellowshipping with Him. And there was just this deliverance in my heart, just this love that was overflowing. So even when she came to the room, I was just at peace, and I felt so free. I felt so happy. I just realized that, my God, it's not good to hold someone in your heart, or it's not good to have unforgiveness in your heart. Trust me, you will feel so good if you can just pray to the Lord to help you forgive, because it's actually not easy. You won't want to, but there is so much joy and peace when you actually let go. So bitterness is also, you know, a bowl of shackles. So there's deliverance when you come to God and get those of love from Him to love other people.
Mm. Yes, as you were talking, it just struck me that bitterness does not necessarily only affect older people.
Yeah.
Even children in primary school,
yes.
secondary school
yeah.
can be, they are prone to it, they can, you know, experience bitterness. So I think it's also important for parents as well to look
yes.
at, because the children may not understand
yes.
what's going on with them.
They might not know their
yes.
parents.
They might not know, because children are envious. When I was younger, I experienced envy. So all these traits that we've mentioned, they're also found in children.
Mm-hmm.
So it's important for parents as well to look out for certain traits that they're noticing in their
and
children and to combat it at that point they're noticing it, so they don't grow up with it and it becomes more difficult to handle or it causes more harm
yeah.
over time when it comes, you know.
Just like the Bible says that, do not just about to say that you should not provoke your children. Mm. You can provoke them by neglecting and annoying them and feeling like they are still children, they don't understand.
Yes.
But all those things are taking roots in their hearts. And when they grow up, you'll be so shocked that you'll be like, how my parents left me when I was 4. And you just be,
it's how true, right?
we didn't know. But then when you are observant, you realize that these children, they are like sponges. I think at some ages, they are like sponges that take in everything. So, because you are cautious at that point, they won't really have that much problem. And they'll have less problems.
I just want to beg our parents to watch out for children, because children find themselves, when they leave home, you don't have control, and you don't have control over who they meet with. So the foundation is very important. So parents, please help us. I'm still a child. Please help us. Help us not to be a slave, not to build a mobile prison in our hearts. I see the Lord helping us in Jesus' name.
Another point came to my head on how to combat bitterness. The people you surround yourself with also matters. So your association, your friends, are they the ones that are fueling your bitterness, your envy, your negative emotions, or they're the ones that they stand with you in the place of prayer and they're, you know, interceding on your behalf, and they're making you see the, you know, they're taking you through the word of God. This is what the Bible says, and they're praying for you, you know, standing for you, standing the gap for you. So your friendship, your association, the company you keep is also very, very important.
Are they the ones that will tell you true talk?
Wow, I have been such an amazing time with you, Kelly Evangelista.
We discussed it together.
Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
So we'd like you to at least just, you know, pray for the viewers and for some who also are not in their own surprise.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for this topic you have highlighted for us. As men that are listening to us now, watching now, you know deep in your heart that you have lost it. You don't even know Jesus at all. So your body is a great embodiment of bitterness. You hate Jesus Christ. You are, I am begging you, as we are assisting you in the place of prayer, wherever you are, confess to God. Tell God to help you. You cannot be delivered from sin by yourself, but from Jesus Christ. Ask God to forgive you your sins. Father, we are praying for these ones that you are touching right now. Those that you are touching, we are praying that you establish them in you in the mighty name of Jesus. Make their path straight in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, build them up in your righteousness in the mighty name of Jesus. Jesus, we are praying for as many that are watching us. The sister listening to this now that was abused by her parents, we are praying, Lord, a fuel for forgiveness. Lord Jesus, help these hearts to forgive her parents in the mighty name of Jesus. Help these hearts to love her parents in the mighty name of Jesus. We will cling to the power of salvation in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for what you have done.
Thank you,
for in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you so much for coming once again.
Thank you so much.
Yes, so and to follow him on social media, his handles are?
Yes, on Instagram, Toby_Olumuyiwa.
And on Twitter.
And, don't let us do Twitter.
On Facebook?
Yes, that is my pulpit. Facebook, Toby Olumuyiwa. And also I have a page, Toby Olumuyiwa Official. That's where I post my inspirational write-ups, videos, and everything that has to do with
ranting.
Yes, ranting. So Toby Olumuyiwa, then Toby Olumuyiwa Official.
All right, so I believe you've gotten that. Yes, so thank you once again for joining us, and see you next time. Bye.